It was kept on the mantelpiece above the open hearth. As a result of a minor earthquake, the rock fell and rolled into the fiery coals. When Ada returned to home that evening, there was on the mantelpiece a very small dragon. The rock was no ordinary rock. It was a dragon egg which had hatched Drac. Once over the shock of having a new companion, Ada cared for the dragon as best she could. But one day it bit her. As she healed, Ada began to notice strange, unusual things. She had better eyesight, sharper hearing, and the ability to tolerate heat. She could also hear dragons from history crying out in fear and in pain as they were being hunted and attacked by humans. Distraught by the agony of dragons, Ada borrowed her father's arm-mounted time-traveling device and traveled back through time to rescue the dragons. But when Ada turned up, the dragons, fearing humans, disappeared, flying into their lairs in the craggy mountains. Ada was unable to follow on foot. She needed to be able to fly, so she returned to the workshop to construct a thermonuclear-powered pair of wings. Her thoughts were many, and possibilities were endless. She struggled night and day, day and night, in an attempt. Various methods were applied to the science. She was unable to do it, sometimes failing only partially, other times failing completely. Realizing that she needed to try something that would be a bit more impulsive, she thought of steam. And it worked. Gathering all of her implements about her, she began to construct. Working day and night, she succeeded in acquiring the ability to fly. Ada was then accepted by the dragons and was able to follow them. And instead of trying to capture dragons, which proved to be rather a hazardous undertaking, she gathered up the dragon eggs. She then transported them not only to a different time, but a parallel dimension where dragons were safe from human hunters. This is why they have become myths and legends. Ada has worked tirelessly to rescue the dragons. They are fewer and fewer left in our time dimension, however. If someone should happen to give you a rather unusual stone, look after it carefully. So very, very carefully, and keep it warm. It may one day hatch into a dragon.